गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स,
गुड आफ्टरनून सर।
एक्चुअली एज पर शेड्यूल वी हैव टू कंटिन्यू दिस दैट नावर स्कीम्स, बट ड्यू टू सम टेक्निकल प्रॉब्लम दैट कंसर्न फैकल्टीज दैट लैपटॉप इज नॉट एट रिकवर्ड, वी ट्राइड अप टू नो बट इट्स नॉट कंप्लीटेड, सो दैट्स व्हाई आई एम डिसाइडेड टू कंटिन्यू क्लास. Okay, we'll whatever that class we'll arrange, we are adjusting somewhere in next week. Okay, and we will continue. Don't worry about that. Then coming to today's class, yesterday we discussed up to pulses, classification of crops up to pulses. Now coming to next one is feeds or fodder crops or forage crops. We all know that livestock or animal husbandry is the part and parcel of our Indian agriculture. That's why as we require food grains and also commercial crops for our regular needs, same time for our livestock or cattle, feed and fodder also the same level of importance is there for feed and fodder. Forage vegetative matter or fresh or preserved vegetative matter utilized as a feed purpose for animals or cattle. It includes hay, silage, pasturage, and fodders. Bajra, napier grass, gunya grass, fodder sorghum, fodder maize, lucerne, then deshmanthus, dinanath grass. There is so many fodder crops is there. That is your grassiest fodder crops, means your cereal fodder crops, and your leguminous fodder crops. Both are there. Then hybrid napier is one of the cross between napier and your bajra, that is hybrid napier. It also called as chambu napier, bajra napier hybrid. This is a perennial grass fodder. It process more tillers and leaves than napier grass and is more vigorous and higher in fodder yield and quality. It's one of the fodder grass, that is actually a cross between your bajra and napier grass. Then next one is gunya grass. It is a tallest grass, 1 to 4.5 meters tall. It will up to that much height it will reach. Then tufted and fast growing, highly palatable to animals and perennial grass. It has short creeping rhizomes. Here the propagation material is creeping rhizomes. Then cereal fodders, coming to cereal, other cereal fodder, these all are grasses or cereal fodder. Coming to your particular whatever they are, cereal fodders, cultivated cereals. Then fodder maize, what is the variety? We are discussing about fodder maize. What are the different varieties related to fodder maize? Yes, varieties, fodder maize varieties, please. Anyone? Fodder maize varieties. You can speak out now. Why you are texting? Okay. Otherwise, I have to go back and check. Anybody? Yes, Sindhu.
African tall.
Other than African tall.
Pratapchari.
Okay. Pratapchari, J6000, something there are the some of the varieties is there. Fodder maize, what is the seed rate for fodder maize?
40 to 50.
Okay. Maize is mostly grown as a kharif crop. Fodder maize sowing in June, July. In South India, it makes best growth in Rabi and also in summer also. It gives a good fodder yield, but generally grown in your kharif. It can be grown throughout the year with irrigation pressure. If the irrigation availability is there, then as for fodder purpose, they can grow throughout the year. And generally, we harvest at 50% flowering stage, or 50 days after your this one, days after sowing. Then next one is fodder sorghum. Okay, cholam or jawar. Sorghum is a drought-resistant annual crop. It grows in tropical climate with a temperature range up to 30 degrees, 35 degrees Celsius. Okay, 25 to 35 degrees Celsius. This farmers there also in there here also a sweet sorghum type fodder jawar is there. So jawar is there. Otherwise, your mal dhandi is the one. Other than your usa chari, some of the varieties is there. We will discuss. Then coming to leguminous fodders. For leguminous fodder, coming under leguminous fodder category, your cowpea or lobia or your cowpea. Okay, somewhere in the Andhra, the alasandalu. This is another fodder made generally using legume fodder. There is a question previously in one exam. Which of the following crop is a vegetable crumb pulse? Vegetable crumb pulse crumb fodder crop.
We can use pods
for vegetable purpose and table purpose, and same time it's a fodder crop and same time it's a pulse crop. You can use these seeds also as a dal purpose. So this is about cowpea. What is the scientific name?
Vigna unguiculata.
Unguiculata sinensis. Okay. Then grown in tropics, subtropics, and warm temperature regions during Kharif, Rabi, and summer season. It is an annual crop. It is grown for feeding in grain form, direct feeding for hay making also generally using, for ensiling in mixture with sorghum or maize. For silage or ensiling purpose, mixing with your cereals plus legumes is gives good quality fodder, good quality silage. Then Deshmanthus, that is Hedgelusen. Generally those from rural background or even some hilly sides or even some forest sides, this is a generally Hedgelusen, generally found in forest areas or even non-cultivated areas. This is generally non-cultivated plant, but nowadays this is also cultivating for fodder purpose. Hedgelusen. Deshmanthus is a perennial crop, Hedgelusen. It is grows throughout the year under irrigation and during June to October as a rain feed crop. That is leguminous. These both are leguminous. Then there is some of the fodder crops, forage crops. That is your bersim. Okay, Trifolium alexandrium, that is leguminous. Then coming to Lucerne, Medigova sativa. Okay, then your cowpea, Pignea unguiculata. Then cluster bean, gur. Yesterday I told that is a gur gum purpose also. It's also is a fodder purpose also. Some of the varieties available for fodder cluster bean also, other than your vegetable. It is also your cluster bean also for vegetable purpose, gum purpose, and fodder purpose. Okay. Campesis, Tetragonolova, then sweet clover, that is Syngi, Melitotus alba, then Paragrass, Bacharia mitica. This is Paragrass. What is the specification about Paragrass? It is resistant, tolerant to water logging. Okay. Other than your paddy, your Paragrass also, it can survive in waterlogged condition. Okay. Paragrass, Bacharia mitica, then Napier grass, that is Penicetum purpureum, then your oats, Avena sativa, red clover. Okay, this is seed clover, Melitotus alba, red clover, Trifolium, Castanus, then Ceresia, that is Lespodeza cuneata, then Velvet bean, that is Mucana pyrcinsins, then common vetch is Vicia sativa. All these are comes under your leguminous fodders. Then Kudj. Some of these are even not cultivated also. Okay, Yersinia tamberingia, then for indigo fera hirsuta, then rhodan grass, the rhodas grass, Cholis guyana. Sometimes this is a scientific name they are asking in match the pairs or somewhere, or what is the scientific name of rhodan grass or like that. So just remember some of the important ones. Rhodan grass.
Tell which are important, sir.
Actually, you can have to remember anyhow your Bersim lucerne, then Bersim lucerne cover, then Paragrass, Napier grass. These are the other than that, your this Rhodas grass, then your Hedgelusen. Okay, these are the, some of the Sudan grass. Okay, these are some of the important fodder crops. Okay, out of that, your legumes, Versim, lucerne, and clover. Okay, anyhow, cowpea we can remember. Okay, that's no problem. That are the some here they are given oats. Oats is yeah. So from here, paragrass, napier grass. These all are gramineae. Your Poaceae family, gramineae family, and this your versim, lucerne, cowpea, cluster bean, and sweet clover. Up to this, your leguminous. Then coming to paragrass, napier grass, oats, red. All these are under grass family. Okay. Then rhodas grass. I will give one chart also after this class, or I will provide whatever that some regular powder crops, regular cultivated powder crops. Then Sudan grass, that is sorghum, Sudanense. Then Italian grass. Some of this grass is not even available in our country, but just to have a look to get some idea. Then Turpedo grass.
In this powder maize also the Stazel and Cobble emerge, sir, or just only these will be there?
Yeah, after 50 days, 50% flower, 50% flowering will generally harvest for powder purpose.
Okay.
So the some of that, not completely, that cob formation is not going through there, going there complete. So at 50% flowering means just the initiation of others, what SL and whatever that, even sometimes that fertilization also complete after 55 to 60 days. Generally means just your flowering stage starts.
Okay.
Then these are some of the grasses. This is low grass, and some of the weeds also is there given. Okay, that is generally not that much important. You just remember your regular powders other than your crops, your versim, lucerne, then your versim, lucerne, then your this one, what is that, your clovers, then here coming to your here rhodas grass, then hedge lucerne, then Sudan grass. These are the some of the, then napier. Generally, mostly they are asking, if they want to ask regarding other than this, your napier grass or that your this one, what your hybrid napier. Hybrid napier is a cross between your bajra and napier. The next one, fiber crop, that is about fodder. We have a detailed class on fodder crops. Okay, then fiber crops. There is a fiber is another important component for human life. And coming to fiber crops, there is different type of fiber crops. Fiber is there based on where from we are extracting. Okay, stem fiber, your jute and mesta is a stem fiber where we are extracting fiber from that stem. Then coming to seed fiber. Seed means where we are extracting fiber from seeds, that is your cotton. There is a two type of fibers is there. What is that in cotton? We call this
fuzz and lint.
Fuzz and lint. Which one is economically viable?
Lint.
Lint is generally we are using for your textile purpose, and fuzz is very shorter that fiber that is attached with your seeds, and we are remove that with the delinting. Okay, then next one is stem fiber, that is jute and mesta. Then leaf fiber, that is agave and pineapple. Okay, so coming to here, you can observe there is cotton. You know that cotton, jute, and mesta. Then coming to fiber crops families, jute. There is again jute. Generally, it's there is two types is there, two varieties. That is Castoreus capsularis, Tiliaceae, and another is that is white jute, generally called as a white jute, capsularis, family is Tiliaceae. Then Tossa jute, that is Volatorius, that is Volatorius, Tossa jute. And this the highest production of jute in India, which state? State is which?
West Bengal.
Actually, before independence, India is the one of the largest producer, but after that Bangladesh is bifurcated from India, that is divided, then the some only the small part of that jute cultivating area is remains with India. Then where is the any institute regarding this jute? There is two institutions. One institute, Jute Research Institute. Where is the Indian Institute of Jute and Allied Fibers?
West Bengal.
Yeah, West Bengal. Where is the
Barakpur.
Then where is that another jute technology? Jute Technology Institute is there. जो टेक्नोलॉजी इंस्टीट्यूट, इट्स
लखनऊ,
लोकेटेड कहाँ था? हाँ,
लखनऊ,
जो टेक्नोलॉजी,
कोलकाता और लखनऊ सर,
कोलकाता नॉट लखनऊ, ओके, जो टेक्नोलॉजी इंस्टीट्यूट दैट इज कॉटन टेक्नोलॉजी,
नागपुर,
कॉटन टेक्नोलॉजी
आई थिंक मैसूर,
बॉम्बे, ओके, दैट इज व्हाट वी कॉल, दैट इज सीएफटीआरआई, नॉट सीएफटीआरआई, is cotton technology, cotton fiber technology and research like that is some institute is there, that is CFTRI, CFT, not food technology, that cotton technology, something is there, Sircot, sorry, Sircot, that is Sircot, that is located at Mumbai, and CICR, that is cotton research, that is at Nagpur, same jute research, jute and allied fibers at Barakpur, and jute technology, jute fiber technology, that is at your Kolkata, then that is white door, jute, capsularis, then Tossa jute, this is Volatoris. Then out of these two jutes, which is tolerant to water logging? Yes? One is upland and one is dryland. Okay, we'll discuss. Then coming to cotton. We know that there is a cotton, is two groups. One is your
old
cotton and world cotton. Worldwide cotton means Asiatic cottons, that is your arboreum and herbaceum. We can call this Desi cotton. Your herbaceum generally called as Asiatic cotton, and arboreum is called as a Desi cotton. And then coming to New World cotton, your hirsutum, that is American cotton, also called as American cotton or upland cotton. And then your another is Barbadensis, that is Egyptian cotton or Iceland cotton, sea Iceland cotton. There is four species there. And out of these four species, which is mostly cultivating?
Hirsutum.
Hirsutum is the now presently more than 90% BT hirsutum is cultivating. And there is only one country in the world cultivating the four the species of cotton, that is India. Okay. Then coming to next is Mesta. Again, there is a two species, that is one is Sabdifera and another is, you are not given, I think another is Cannabinus, given now, yeah, that is Cannabinus, okay, one is Mesta having two species, Hibiscus, Sabdifera and Hibiscus, Cannabinus, out of this one is, which one is your Gongura, Sabdifera or Cannabinus?
Sabdifera
is that taller plants. Okay, just check it. Then coming to sun hemp, or Cotylaria gentia, it's also fiber crop. Cotylaria gentia is a fiber crop other than that?
Green manure
crop. Okay.
That is also comes under stem fiber only, sir.
Yeah, stem fiber only. Yes. Then coming to your this one, white rummy, this are some minor, this plant-based, that thing is there, green rummy, white rummy, that is, this is also using for your current nodes and all those things. Okay, Bomeria niva and Bomeria utilizes, then sisal or agave, sisalenia, then urena, kango jute, that is urena also known, called as kango jute, urena, lobata, these are the some of the your fiber crops. Then next category is your sugar crops. Okay, sugar crops, those we know for growing for sugar purpose, to extract sugar. Crops grown for production of sugar and starch. There is how many sugar crops is available?
Three,
other
sir.
Than this sugar cane and sugar beet, there is in some places there also the extraction of sugar or gur from your sorghum also is under experiment or somewhere they are doing, but basically these are the two sugar crops, that is sugar cane and sugar beet. And your sugar cane is mostly tropical and subtropical crop, and your sugar beet is temperate crop. What is the scientific name of sugar beet?
Beta
vulgaris.
What is the family?
Chenopodiaceae.
Okay, and coming to your sugar cane, we already discussed that there is a two type, one is Indian cane and another is tropical cane, or that is Gunia cane. Can you tell me what is the scientific name of Indian cane?
Kakaram spontaneous.
Kakaram
Kakaram barbary.
Kakaram barbary or officinalis or spontaneous?
Barbary.
Officinalis.
Any person related to this barbary or one person, one scientist, well-known sugarcane breeder, who is that?
Narayan.
Narayan, not Narayan. Other than that. Someone worked on that sugarcane and the based on that, he is introduced this barbary and officinal something. Okay. Then sugarcane, your noble cane, that is Sankaram officinarum, that is tropical cane generally. Okay. And another one is North Indian cane, that is Sankaram barbary, OAC. Then another one, your Chinese cane, sugarcane, Chinese sugarcane, that is Sankaram sinensis. Then edible cane, that is Edula. Then sugar beet, Vita vulgaris, potato, Solanum tuberosum solanaceae. Okay. So is, okay, sorry. This is wrongly kept Solanum with the potato. Okay, then coming to this research institute, Kariga, related to sugarcane. What are the different research institutes there?
Sugarcane Breeding Institute, Coimbatore.
SBI, Coimbatore. Why that is in Coimbatore only?
It is favorable condition for the
breeding. It is favorable condition for the breeding purpose.
Flower.
When it was established? It's in pre-independence era only. That is at 1912. Okay. Then that is SBI. Other than SBI? Other than SBI. Indian Institute of Sugarcane? Indian Institute of Sugarcane is there?
No.
Where is it?
Lucknow.
Lucknow. Then coming to this again, this sugarcane regarding to based on their duration, it's again classified into two categories. That is, one is Adshali and Ekshali. What is that, Adshali and Ekshali?
Adshali, 18 months.
It takes 1.5 year almost. And Adshali crop from where? Means generally it's Adshali crop taken in which part of India?
Northern.
Northern or Southern? Adshali crop.
Southern India.
Exhali? Southern. Generally Maharashtra and part of Maharashtra and this area they are taking Adshali crop. Okay. And another important practice is here is your ratooning. What is ratooning?
After the harvesting of the crop.
Regrowth from stubbles. Okay. The ratooning also is the most widely practicing in this crop. Okay. Remaining thing we'll discuss later. And that is about sugar cane and sugar beet. Then is there sugar beet cultivation in India?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Some in northern India, there is in some parts. It's a your sugar cane is tropical crop and your sugar beet is completely temperate crop. It requires cold climate for its growth. Okay. That is some parts of your North India it's cultivating. And your another thing for your sugar cane, southern your South India sugar cane yield is higher or North Indian sugar cane yield is higher?
South India is higher.
Sugar
North India, sir.
What is the
sugar? North India yield is higher.
North India yield is higher, sir.
Why?
Suitable environment conditions.
Suitable environment condition.
But sugar content is high in Indian cane. That's why we
recovery.
Call both to get noble recovery.
Recovery, what is the general recovery, average recovery in India? That is 9 to 10.
10.
Okay. And that is the recovery percentage also highest in the world. That mostly means the maximum recovery we are getting in India. And another is there generally another to estimate that maturity or to determine maturity that BRICS index also the one instrument is there, BRICS one instrument. Based on that BRICS index, what is the average BRICS index to indicate the maturity or to assess the maturity?
18, sir.
16 to 18%. Okay, then coming to this beta vulgaris genopodium. Okay, this genopodium family beta vulgaris sugar beet. Any specification related to nutrient? Nutrients, plant nutrient. Here, sugar beet related to something, some plant nutrient, what is that?
Sodium indicator.
Sodium, it's required sodium for its growth, but generally other plants is not required. There is cyanobacterium is a sodium is essential beneficial nutrient for your sugar beet, and that's why it's indicator plant. Then coming to other ones, spices and condiments. Crop plants are their products used to flavor or to add a flavor or taste and color to your feeds. Means whatever your food products, your food additives works like food additives. It has a fresh or preserved food. Those plants are their products. Add flavor or taste and color to the your prepared fresh food or preserved foods. That is your ginger, garlic, fenugreek, cumin, turmeric, chilies, onion, coriander. Okay, and all these things. Out of this, which one is not indigenous? Ginger, garlic, fenugreek, cumin, turmeric, chilies, onion, coriander. Which one is not indigenous? Not one. Which one is exotic crop? Introduced from outside? Foreign crop? Out of this, your chili, mirchi, capsicum, whatever that you say, this one is introduced. Not it's native. It's introduced by European, that Portuguese. Okay. Then coming to drug crops, your tobacco. Again, there is two species. What is the family?
Solanaceae.
What are the two species? What are the two species?
Nicotianum robustum.
Okay, Solanum nicotianus and Solanum robustum. Then other than that, based on that curing, yes, based on curing and the based on products they are using, there is different classification. They are chewing, then flocute tobacco. Okay, different types. We'll discuss that one. Then coming to research, what is the where is it located? Research institute.
Rajahmundry.
What is that central? Okay, central.
Tobacco research.
CTRI, Rajahmundry. Then what about tobacco board? Tobacco board.
Rajahmundry.
Board is that Guntur. Okay. Then BD tobacco. BD tobacco at Anand, Gujarat. Okay. Then. This is something about tobacco. Then just a minute. Someone is texting. Oh, okay, okay. Then tobacco, there is two species. One is Nicotiana and another is Robusticum. Generally cultivating. And that, what are the difference? Yes, Shweta. Shweta, please.
Sorry, sir, by mistake.
Okay, then that is there is a institute that is research institute CTRI that at Rajahmundry and tobacco board at Guntur. And based on this, what is the difference, basic difference between your Nicotiana and Robustum? Robustum
nicotine content and the leaf size, sir.
What is the range for Nicotiana?
0.5 3.5, sir.
Okay, then in case of your this one Robustum up to 8, is it? What is the range for Robustum? Robustum?
I forgot, sir.
Okay, I think as per my knowledge, that is up to 8 or I think something. Okay, means range that is up to 5 to 8, whatever that 0. I will check it. Okay, other than that, here another aspect is related to tobacco. This tobacco crop generally called as a negative crop. It's a negative crop. Negative. Okay, negative good, negative crop like that. Okay. Then your mentha, this is mint, or sorry, this mint is there. There is also using for it's extract from this crop is using for different aspects. Okay, in oils, mint oil, and your other culinary purposes, all those things there. Then coming to necrotic and fumaritus and other miscellaneous crops. Plants are products used for stimulating, numbering, or dowsing or rizzling effects. Generally, tobacco or ganja, whatever that is, opium poppy, these are our negative crops. And Nicotiana tobacco and rustica, two species. Then coming to your beverages, here we can call as a plantation crops also. These are the your tea, Camelina sinensis, TACA, then coffee arabica, robusta, then coca, coca, or theobroma, coca, then your chicory, chicorium intibus. Is chicory is directly we are consuming? What is the important of chicorium? What is the use of chicory? Chicory, we are mixing it with coffee. Is it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. And other than this, any other other the related thing is the related to chicory? Chicorium intibus.
It's a weed, no, sir?
Yeah, it's a weed. Okay, other than there is a one plant using for a mutation purpose. What is that? Doubling of chromosome?
Colchicine.
That is colchicine. Plant is from where we are obtaining obtain that colchicine? From where, which plant? Just check it once. Okay. The what is the source? That is calcium is obtaining from one plant. Which is that plant? What is the which from which plant? Okay. Then T. Camelina sinensis, that is TAC. Then coming to coffee, that is coffee arabica rubiaceae. Then coca, that is coca. Theobroma coca, that is Stericuliaceae. Then another one is chicory, chicorium intibus, that is ostraceae or compositae. These are the beverage crops. Then this is about some of the crops. This some of these are not that much important. Okay, then coming to next classification is seasonal classification. Okay, there is a generally in case of India there is two basic seasons, otherwise three. That is kharif, based which season is based on your southwest monsoon. We are already discussed about the southwest monsoon. Is what is monsoon generally? What is monsoon? Anybody? What is monsoon? How many types of monsoons is there? There is
onset of rainfall.
Two monsoons.
Types of monsoons: southwest and northeast.
Okay. What is monsoon? Monsoon is nothing but trade winds.
The rainfall.
Trade winds, not rainfall. It's a trade winds, sir. That winds blowing
coming,
yeah, coming from that Asian Ocean, that is from towards that from Hindu Ocean to towards India, it's enter into India. That is trade winds. Whatever that winds that carry the moisture, and once it's enter into that land mass, that moisture, whatever that moisture condense, and further that may forms in cloud forms, and further whenever that favorable condition, whatever that pressure is increased in that clouds going to burst, and we are getting rains. So monsoon is a trade winds. You just remember this much. Okay. Then, other than that, next is there is based on that there is three seasons. One is kharif, another is rabi, and summer. Summer. Otherwise, there is another terminology: rainy season, post rainy season, and jet season. Jet means. Jet is a season, name of one season. Which season is called as jet season?
Summer.
Your summer called as jet season. Then rainy, your June to September. Then coming to post rainy, the rainy or kharif, then post rainy, that is from October to your up to November. Oh, sorry, October to your December or January. Then there is another term is the spring. Spring generally, we consider from January to January, February, March, up to some 15th, first fortnight of March, that is spring season. Then summer season, generally from March to March, April, May, that is summer season. Okay, generally based on that is four seasons. But generally for our agriculture point of view, generally we are considering most major seasons is two seasons. One is kharif and one is rabi, rainy and post-rainy. Then other than that, spring season is also there. Then summer also is there. Okay. Crops grown during June, July to September, October is called as kharif, which requires a warm, wet weather during their major period of growth and short day length. Those crops grown during this season is a, their photoperiodically they are short day plants and requires warm weather. Requires warm weather. We already discussed. I already told that most of crops of your kharif season are short day crops. Okay, that is your rice, maize, castor, and groundnut, whatever most of your field crops. Then coming to rabi. Rabi crops is long day crops mostly. Okay, temperate crops. It generally start from October to up to January, December or January. Then here some of the kharif crops: rice, corn, maize, wheat. Sorry, wheat is your rabi cereal. Okay, these are the kharif: rice, maize, soybean, sugarcane, then groundnut, cotton. Even though your cotton continues up to December, it's the annual. Okay, what is considered as a your kharif? Your rice, generally we can cultivating in some areas where irrigation available in 3 seasons, otherwise 2 seasons. Okay, sugarcane also is long, 360 days crop, exali or 18 months crop in case of your arshali. Chickpea, your Bengal gum, rabi, wheat rabi, oat rabi, mustard rabi, brocoli rabi. Okay, these are the some of the crops. Rabi crops are post monsoon crops. Crops grown during October to November, from October, November to January, February. Means sowing carried out in October, November, and harvesting in January, February. Requires cold, dry weather. There is a warm weather, and here is cold, dry weather. Major for required for weather growth and development of crops. Mostly long day plants. Photophyllotism is long day. Temperate crops: wheat, mustard, barley, oats, potato, Bengal gram, bersim, cabbage and cauliflower. These are the were rabi crops: wheat, mustard, barley, oats, Bengal gram, bersim, cabbage and cauliflower. Then coming to our Z season crops or summer crops: crops grown during February, March to May, June. Okay, which requires warm, dry weather for growth. Warm, dry weather. Okay, longer day, length for flowering. Long photophyllotism is generally long day plant. Your black gram, green gram, and sesame, very short duration crops. Means here in Z crops, summer season, there is your evapotranspiration requirement is more and water availability is less. That's why we cultivate short duration crops and which having highly drought tolerant. That is your black gram, green gram, sesame, cowpea, and some of the green manuring crops we will cultivate during this period. Then difference between kharif and rabi crops. Kharif crops are the crops which are sown at the beginning of the rainy season, that is between April and May, or even monsoon in case of our Indian condition. That is, monsoon enters into India after first week of June. Then rabi crops are the crops that are sown at the end of the monsoon, at the beginning of the winter season, between September to October. Other than this thing, rabi crops also called as most of the rabi crops in some case in dryland area, even as rabi crops cultivating based on stored soil moisture. Sometimes in case of dry tracts, they are not cultivating any crops during kharif. They are cultivating the field, they are carried out tillage and removing weeds and all those things, but keeping fallow and cultivating crop in rabi based on whatever the stored moisture in kharif crop, that is residual, based on residual soil moisture, they will cultivate fallow followed by crop in rabi. Kharif fallow followed by crop in rabi. So that is this thing. Then this kharif crops are known as a monsoon crop. Rabi crops are also known as a winter or spring crops. Then here coming to our north southwest monsoon. Okay, then another northeast monsoon. I already told you northeast monsoon only predominant in which part of India?
Tamil Nadu
and surrounding parts. Okay, your Tirupati, Chittoor, Kadapa part of the Andhra Pradesh and Tamil Nadu, Chennai. Okay, then your kharif crops are depends on the rainfall pattern. That's your kharif crops mostly based on the onset of monsoon, and rabi crops not affected by the rainfall. And most of the rabi crops are, one is based on the stored soil moisture, and another the maximum rabi crops is based on irrigation availability or irrigation facilities available at that farm level. Then major kharif crops are rice, maize, cotton, jawar, bajra. Major rabi crops: wheat, gram, peas, barley, etc. Then I already told you another thing, there is yield of rabi crops or rabi maize or rabi crops is more compared to your kharif crops. Why? We are already discussed. Only the basic reason: cloudiness in the kharif, that reduce the photosynthesis, and another is due to that cloudy and humid weather, your pest and disease attack also is more, and due to the continuous rains, your weed management also difficult in kharif. That's why the yield is lesser compared to rabi. Then coming to next one is, it requires a lot of water and hot weather to grow in case of kharif, and in case of rabi crop, a warm climate is required for seed germination and cold climate for the growth of the crops. Initially, rabi crops required cool climate, but at the time of harvesting and seed development, they require warm climate. Then flowering requires short day in case of kharif and long day in case of rabi. Harvesting months from September to October, generally our kharif crops generally we harvest and during September, October, and here in case of March, April, or in case of January, February, based on the duration of the crop or variety. Then that is okay. Next aspect is according to ontogeny. What is ontogeny means? The life cycle or growth period. Based on that, we are divided or classified crops into annual crops, biannual crops, and perennial crops. Annual crops are, it's required one season or 1 year for complete its life cycle seed to seed. Your wheat, rice, maize, mustard are the annual crops. Then biannual crops. Coming to biannual crops, lifespan of two consecutive seasons or years. First year, generally they are complete its vegetative growth, and second year, they comes to reproductive development and seed development, reproductive growth. During the second year season, they produce flower stalks from the crown, and after producing seeds, the plant dies. It requires generally 2 years. Your sugar beet, 2 years. Beetroot, 2 years. Carrot, cabbage, radish, all these are biannual crops. So in the first year, they develop vegetative growth, and second year, they develop reproductive or flowering this one, and finally they develop a seed and die. That is biannual crops. Then perennial crops, they generally require more than 1 year. Coming to your field crop, your sugarcane, napier grass are the perennials. Okay. According to suitability of topo sequence or cultivation sequence, crops grown on uplands and crops grown down lowland. Generally here, sometimes we gone through the terms upland crops or lowland crops. Upland crops, leveled elevated land with a drain and all round, means these crops not able to grow in case of waterlogged conditions, require leveled seed bed and drain, and it require well drained soils. Unbounded level land with the drains or drafts. Crops that cannot tolerate water stagnation or water logging comes under this group. Red gram, groundnut, maize, sorghum, cotton, sesamum and napier. These are the some of the crops is very sensitive to water logging. That is red gram, groundnut, maize, sorghum, cotton, sesamum, napier. Crops that requires sufficient soil moisture but cannot tolerate water stagnation. That is potato, sugarcane, upland rice, ragi, wheat, black gram and Bengal gram. These crops is required your moisture up to some extent, some wet condition, but not water stagnation. Can't tolerate these crops. Can't tolerate water stagnation or water lodging. Then coming to lowland crops, the best example of your lowland crop is lowland paddy or your submerged paddy. These lands are provided with the dikes or bunds all around to a stagnated water. Crops that requires abundant supply of water and can withstand prolonged water logged condition. That's your rice or paddy. Okay, there is a special practice involved in case of paddy cultivation, that is lowland paddy cultivation. What is that?
Puddling.
Puddling.
What is the puddling?
It's the preparation of fine bed for transplanting. Yeah.
What is the main advantage of puddling?
Reduce the percolation losses of water.
Reduce the percolation losses of water. It's a collapse the soil structure, whatever the soil structure, and it close means almost it stop the percolation, means downward movement of water, and further it helps to continuous submergence, means continuous water is in that field. That is puddling. Due to puddling, there is a two layers forms. Which are those two layers?
Oxygen layer and reduced layer.
Then where we have to apply fertilizer?
Reduced zone.
To avoid or to overcome the losses, denitrification losses, we have to apply fertilizer in reduced layer. Then other crop is dhancha. Dhancha, what is the scientific name of dhancha? Dhancha. Which type of crop is this one? Dhancha is for what purpose?
Green manure crop.
Yesterday we discussed already, that is Sisbenia rostrata, Sisbenia species. Okay. Then another is paragrass. This is a fodder crop or paragrass. And jute. Okay, jute also is one species. That is, I think, Volatorius is water logging. I'm not sure. I will check once. Okay, Volatorius or Capitalis. Okay, that is also tolerant to water logging. The next is according to source of water, that irrigated or rain fed crops. Irrigated crop generally cultivated under irrigation. Here the source of irrigation may be your canal, your tube well, or your open well, or your tanks, whatever. Artificially we are applying irrigation here. In case of rain fed, completely depends on rainfall. Even though in case of rainfall, we will apply irrigation sometimes. During the long dry spells, we apply irrigation to maintain the crop. That type of irrigation is called as a
life-saving irrigation.
Life-saving irrigation, or other term,
supplementary
irrigation. Okay. From whatever the water harvested in water that farm ponds, we utilize that water in farm pond for save that crop during the long dry spells or monsoon failure. That is life-saving irrigation or supplementary irrigation. Generally, sometimes they are asking question about that. Then next one, according to moisture availability in the soil, that is wetland soils, the soil moisture is allowed to occupy both macro and microspores, that is anaerobic field conditions. Okay, this is generally anaerobic field condition prevails in that type of fields. Crops, your green manure crops like Sisbenia crops and some grasses, your whatever that paragrass is required, that type of wetland fields. Coming to dryland fields, the soil moisture is allowed only into microspores. We know that there is a two type of spores in soil, that is macro and micro. In case of micro, air or water?
Water.
Okay, in case of micro, water is there, and in case of macro is the Air is there. Then what is the percentage of carbon dioxide in your soil microspores or soil? First tell me, higher than atmosphere or lower than atmosphere?
Lower than.
Lower than
higher than higher. Higher than
higher than atmosphere. Then what is the general percentage? Generally,
0.25.
0.25. In case of atmosphere?
0.03.
0.03.
Yes. Okay. Then, okay, that is about this. And generally, these crops required only water or moisture content in only in your microspores. Okay. Other than, just tell me, we are here to discuss here. We'll discuss just a small idea, but tell me, what is the soil composition generally? Soil composition. Okay. Here, there is air and water, means micro and macrospores is there. Other than that, mineral matter is there. How much mineral matter?
5%, sir.
Mineral matter?
45, sir. 45.
Okay, then micro and macro, are this air and water? Around 50. And then yes, remaining, what is remaining 5%?
Organic matter.
Organic matter.
That is general soil composition, we'll discuss again. So, that about dry lands, means here the generally the whatever your upland, it's not the one other way of classification of your wetland and lowland. Then magnitude of soil moisture varies according to the crop. Crops like maize, highly sensitive to excess moisture and drought. Crops tolerant to drought and temporary stagnation. Sorghum are cultivated in this type of field conditions. Okay. Then before that, just tell me here, paddy we are generally cultivating in lowland condition. Generally, plants respirate from which, where? You know, plants also respirate, no? So for that, they require oxygen. Generally, plants respirate from leaves or through roots?
Leaves.
Yes? Through?
Leaves.
Leaves or roots?
Leaves.
Plants, leaves, through leaves, plants uptake oxygen?
Yes.
What is the stomatal mechanism? Oxygen going in or what? Out?
Coming
water
out. Hydraulics well, oxygen.
Oxygen going out inside or outside?
Inside.
CO2 or oxygen?
Outside.
Yes, there is, that is, we are doing the photosynthesis, there is oxygen. Yes. I am asking respiration. Respiration, generally plants observe this oxygen from soil. Okay, mostly. Okay. Then here in the case of your paddy, the entire plant is under anaerobic condition. Okay. So, what is any special structure is there to get aeration or
parenchyma tissue, sir?
Parenchyma tissue.
There is your that shoot modifies into one special structure, that is parenchyma structure. That means that open hollow type of stem, and that further it helps to absorb or oxygen or whatever. So here is the one principle. What is the relevance to this to your Sri? What is Sri first? What is three? Three rice, three paddy.
System of rice intensification.
System of rice intensification. What is that system of rice intensification?
We use the less number of seedlings.
Okay. We give only transplant one seedling and all those things. Here, we are getting more than 4 times or 5 times of tillers, higher, more than triple or double tillers than your lowland paddy. Why so? There generally, in case of Sri, we are not cultivating under your this water stagnation condition or lowland condition. There generally we are keep general just a wet condition. So that time there is a generally this paddy plant use more energy or more synthesis to uptake oxygen or that to make that parenchyma tissue and all those things. Here that need of energy is not required to make that parenchyma tissue, that energy is shifted to produce more tillers. That's why there is more tillers means automatically your yield will be increased. That's why there is a someone is claiming that I got 120 bags of paddy, 120 quintals of paddy through Sri. Okay, now come back. according to moisture availability is over, then according to suitability of the textural group, okay, crop suitable for to sandy, there is a how many textures generally? Total textural groups.
12, sir.
12 groups is there. Your sandy loam, sandy clay, your sandy loam, then clay loam, okay, like that, then all the things, your silty loam, silty clay, okay, all that 12 structures is 12 textures is there, okay. Then what is texture and what is structure? Texture and structure.
Texture is the relative proportions of texture.
Okay, there is how many basic textural components is there? Textural components is there?
Three.
That is your silt,
sand,
silt, clay. Out of the sand, silt, clay, that are three textural components. This proportion of arrangement is proportion. That proportion, how much silt is there or how much clay is there? That is texture. Okay, and that is generally not going to change. Okay, and your structure is the arrangement of this thing.
Arrangement.
The structure. Okay, and this structure is more important in case of your crop production. Okay, and generally more suitable structure.
Crumbly
and granular. Okay, then coming to your textural classes, texture even here. Sandy means more number of macropores. So your water holding capacity is less. And means the most of the times that crop is going to face water stress, moisture stress. In case of clay, more microspores, so water holding capacity is more. So here water logging problem is there. So we generally out of these three, which soils having maximum porosity?
Clay soils.
Okay.
Clay soils.
Clay soils having maximum porosity. Even though your sandy soils having more number of macrospores, porosity is not means your size of pores. Number of pores is more in. Porosity is number of pores is more in case of your clay soils. Okay, so based on that textural classes, your sorghum, bajra, green gram, sunflower, potato, onion, and carrot. These crops require your light soils. Sandy soils are sandy texture, sandy loams. It's generally called as a light soils. Also, these soils require light. These crops require light soils. Sorghum, bajra, green gram, sunflower, potato, onion, carrot. Why these soils require light crop? Light soil. These crops require light crop. Light soils
cannot tolerate water
logging. Some crops are water sensitive to water logging, and some are underground root developments.
Yes, most underground root development. Your sunflower, you take your this thing. They are not given groundnut also. Okay, groundnut generally this required water is required to peg in that to penetrate to peg generally that loses structure. I mean that's why. Then green gram, broad gram, this too is not that much tolerant to your water logging and require more aeration. And your potato, onion, carrot are underground pots. That's why. Then coming to next one is medium texture soils. Crop suitable to silty loam soils, medium texture soil. Your jute, sugarcane, maize, cotton, mustard, tobacco, Bengal gram, red gram, and coffee. Here I am again telling you, yesterday also I told you, Bengal gram, it's require rough seed bed or coarse seed bed. General, most of them they are asking. Okay. Then coming to next one is crop suitable to clay loams, means your heavy soils. That is rice, wheat, barley, linseed, lentil, paragrass, gunia grass, marvel grass, all this. Those soils required heavy, those crops required heavy soils are clay loams, means those are somewhat susceptible, tolerant to water logging condition. Then, according to tolerance to problem soils, this is important, more important for any competitive exam, according to tolerance to problematic soils. Okay. What is the problematic soil? There is based on the normally the problematic soil decided based on the pH or soil reaction. Okay. The, if the soil is pH is less than 7, then generally they are called as a acidic soils. That is less than 5, then that is more acidic or strongly acidic soils. Then if pH more than 7 or more than 8, then that is saline, then alkali or sodic. Saline, alkali, sodic, and saline alkali or alkali, saline alkali. This is the four terms which are both are same, which both are same, saline, alkali, sodic, and saline alkali. Yes, which both, there is two terms are same, common.
Alkali sodic. And sodic are same, sir.
Yes, sodic or alkali are the common, they are, don't confuse them. Then which soils is called as a white alkali?
Calcium.
Well, sodic soil or sodic soils are alkali soil or your saline soil. Which soils is called as a white alkali and which is black alkali? Sodochak?
Sodochak.
Which is white alkali?
Sodochak.
Black alkali. Sodochak means which soils? Yes, saline soils or alkali soils?
Alkali.
Alkali soils means your sodic soils only, na? Alkali and sodic, both are same, na?
Yes, sir.
So, that is. Then your saline soils. Saline soils means what? Where your magnesium and calcium, magnesium carbonate, calcium carbonate and other sulfates and carbonates and sulfates of this magnesium and calcium is dominated. That's why it is saline. Okay. Then in case of your sodic or alkali, sodium, carbonates, bicarbonate, sulfates, okay, that whatever that is, dominated. Okay. So, that is your sodic. And coming to here, acidic, and then is another term is that saline alkali. That is some of mixed property, something, both of there is dominant, but the properties, mixed properties is there. That is means transition, at a transition zone. Okay. Tolerant to acidic soils, your wet rice or lowland rice, potato and mustard. These crops are acid. Then tell me before that, which soils are generally acidic in nature? High rainfall area or dry land area?
High rainfall area.
Why? Where is high rainfall? There is whatever the salts present in top layer that is going to leach in down, means into underground. That's why that acidity or pH is increased. Okay. pH is, means acid cells, again, coming if acid cell, then your iron and aluminium are dominated. Okay. So, in case of high rainfall areas or waterlogged areas that are acidic cells. Then in case of dry land areas where there is no rainfall, accumulation of your salts in top layers of soil, that's why that are saline soils. Okay. Then tolerant to acid, your rice, paddy, potato, and mustard. These are the acid tolerant. Coming to saline soils or saline tolerant, chilies, cucurbit, wheat, sorghum, bajra, cluster bean, and barley. Out of this, your barley is mostly tolerant to your saline soils. Okay. This example is more important for many. Mostly they are asking about this crop in many of the competitive exams, all type of competitive exams. Then tolerant to alkali or sodic soil, your barley, again, cotton, Bengal gram, bersim, sunflower, maize, and your sugar beet also is not there. Sugar beet, these all are tolerant to alkali or sodic. Barley, cotton, Bengal gram, bersim, sunflower, maize, sugar beet, these are tolerant to alkali soil. So this is about saline, acidic and alkali. Then coming to tolerant to waterlogged condition, we just discussed that only same. Rice, lowland rice, dancha, paragrass, napier grass, gunya grass, all these things. Then crops tolerant to soil erosion, means degraded soils. That is marvel grass, then groundnut, black gram, rice bean, moth bean, and horse gram. These crops in gully area, means wherever that affected by gullies or ravines, that type of soils, we can cultivate, means degraded soil, we can cultivate these crops to restore the soil fertility. Then next is according to tillage requirements. According to tillage requirements, arable crops and non-arable crops. Arable crops require preparatory tillage, that is fine tillage, potato, tobacco, rice, maize. Non-arable crops not require preparatory tillage, primary tillage, or okay, cultivation of that is paragraphs. Okay, this is about the one of the classification, just terms you can, you have to know. Then according to the depth of the root system, this also some of the times they are asking which is a deep rooted crop, which is shallow rooted crop, like that. Then shallow rooted crops were rice, potato, onion, shallow rooted crops. Then moderately deep rooted. Then here we have to know that deep rooted means up to how much deep. Okay, and shallow means up to how much. Okay, what is the shallow rooted means how much, up to how much depth? What is plow sole depth first? What is plow sole depth?
Up to 5 centimeters.
5 centimeters plow sole depth. Sole depth. What is the weight of
15 centimeters?
Soil of 1 hectare.
Sir.
What is the weight of 1 hectare soil up to plow sole depth? What is the plow sole depth? Generally, we consider 15 centimeters is a plow sole depth. Okay. Then coming to short rooted, deep rooted, or medium rooted, what is that? What is the different depth, level of depth? Short rooted?
30.
30 short. Then medium?
60 centimeters.
15 to 25. Up to 25, that is short rooted, or 20-35, then 30 to 60, medium,
medium.
60, that is
deep root.
Then shallow rooted crops, your rice, potato, and onion. Moderately deep rooted, wheat, groundnut, castor, and tobacco. Then deep rooted, your maize. Actually, your maize not actually, okay then, cotton and sorghum. Then very deep rooted, sugarcane, safflower, lucerne and red gram. Just remember, wherever the crops, that is, one is long duration crops, another is dry land, mostly dry land crops or dry crops. The safflower is very deep rooted because mostly cultivated during the kharif season, rabi season, and mostly depends on stored soil moisture. Then we have lucerne and red gram. These are the very deep rooted. Deep rooted cotton, sorghum, very deep rooted sugarcane, safflower, lucerne and red gram. Then rooting depth. This is another classification. Okay. As for this, actually, okay, they are given the shallow rooted, they are given up to 60. Okay, I also check whatever I was told, that is as per TDS classification given by Chrisar. This is okay. Shallow rooted, just you remember this and we'll discuss on that same. I will also refer once. Shallow rooted crops, 60 centimeters, cauliflower, cabbage, onion, potato, lettuce, rice. What is the basis? Okay. Then moderately rooted crops, carrots, French bean, garden pea, chili, okay, moss mullein, tobacco, wheat, castor, banana, whatever they are given. Deep rooted, they are given 120 centimeters and above, cotton, tomato, watermelon, maize, sorghum, sugar beet, soybean, pearl millet. Okay. What actually I was told, that is up to 25 to 35 centimeters and 30 to 60 and say above 60, that is based on tillage. Okay, the tillage depth, shallow till and medium till. Okay, anyhow, I will refer this one again. Then, where is that? Okay, then coming to here, deep rooted lucerne, citrus, apple, guava, or the plantation or horticulture crops. Okay, then next one is the knowledge of rooting depth is essential for scheduling of irrigation, scheduling time and quality, quantity of irrigation is required. Shallow rooted crops require frequent and light irrigations. Deep rooted crops require less but heavy irrigations. Then according to the tolerance to hazardous weather condition, tolerant to frost. This is a frost is one of the major problem in your temperate areas, especially your north India in winter season. Your sugar beet and beetroot, these both crops are tolerant to frost, and most of other crops are not tolerant, means susceptible to frost. Then coming to cold tolerant, cold or chilling tolerance or freezing tolerance. That is potato, cabbage and mustard. These all are the rabi crops. Okay, also tolerant for your chilling injury or freezing injury, cold tolerant. Then coming to drought tolerant, dryland crops, bajra, jawar, barley, safflower and castor. These are the drought tolerant crops. Then next, coming to according to method of sowing and planting, direct seeded crops, whether the seeds are sown directly, either dry or sprouted, for upland rice, wheat, jawar, bajra, groundnut, most of the seeds are direct sown. Then planted crops, where plants, pods are planted directly. Here in sugarcane, what is the propagation method, propagation material in sugarcane? Sets. There is again different type of that sets is there. There are different type of propagation material is there. Generally, we call as a sets. In case of potato, what is the size of potato, is ideal size of potato for seed purpose? Okay. They are given some weight. What is the weight of ideal potato for seed purpose? They are given that 2.5 grams like that. That is the ideal potato. That potato registration they are found. They are recommended. That is by, what is the size? 2.5 grams sized seeds. That weight seed potatoes, so that tubers is ideal for that is early sprouting and all those things. Other than that, here in, what is the true potato seed TPS? True potato seeds, there is a one concept generally produced in some specific areas. TPS generally in case of potato, there is no seeds, only we have to use potatoes for plantation. But there is another, they are developed on true potato seeds, that is developed by, actually initially developed by your potato research institute at Peru. And now in India also they are using this TPS. Then coming to sweet potato, napier, gunia grass, here in all this thing, what is the edible part in case of sweet potato? Stem, root, modified stem?
Adventitious.
Then napier grass, gunia grass, okay. Then coming to next one, transplanted crops. Generally, where we raise the nursery and after reach some growth, we have to go for transplanting. Why? What is the advantage of transplanting or nursery?
Better establishment of the plants.
Yes, in the case of generally nursery, will raise more number of seedlings in less area. So that is we can well manage that smaller area. Other than that, we also directive sowing means we are having an intensive farming system, intensive cultivation system. There is a gap between two crops is very less. So that time that to prepare the seed bed and that all those things require time. That's why to overcome that, before harvesting of that whatever your succeeding previous crop, you have to go for nursery, and there already that is raised, means 30 days or 20 days seedlings is already readily available. So that seedling you will transplant, means there is a time also we are saving time also. Then transplanted rice, generally we are using transplanting in rice and some of the vegetables, even ragi, bajra also is there, in tobacco also we are using. Okay, then coming to rice transplanting, there is different methods of rice transplanting is there. Among that is one is Dopang method. What is the Dopang method?
Rising of seedlings in tracer.
Okay. After how many days we have to transplant?
11 to 14.
14, sir.
Okay. In general seedlings, general nursery?
21 days.
21 to 25, okay. What is the area required for your rice crop for 1 hectare in normal nursery? In case of normal,
1,000 meters,
700 to 900 meters.
You can call 1/10 or 1,000. Okay. In case of Dopang?
3 to 4 meter square, sir.
3 to for 1 hectare?
Sorry. Seed rate, sir.
Seed rate, that is okay. Nursery area? Okay. 33? just find out, just check out that. Okay, we'll discuss again. Then coming to your tobacco, then your during tobacco nursery, one special practice is there. What is rubbing or rubbing? What is
rubbing?
Burning of the nursery bed.
On the seed.
Why? Whatever, if any pathogens or whatever is there, okay, to kill all those things, you are rubbing, is the one practice is there. Okay, this is about transplanting. Then coming according to intertillage or earthing up. Some crops require intertillage or earthing up, but we have already discussed the importance of earthing up to support the crops, to overcome the some pest, to defeat and disease, avoid that control. Okay, like sugar cane. Okay, then intertilled crops or intertillage or intercultivation operation is required in case of potato, sweet potato, groundnut, maize, sugar cane, and turmeric. In case of fodder sorghum, Rainanath grass, paragrass. Generally, these crops we are growing in very crowded or high density, and there is not possibility of intercultivation. Then, according to length of the field duration of the crop, field duration of the crop, growth period of the crop. Short duration,
sir.
Yes, Amma. Yes, boss.
In previous slide, intercultivation in sweet potato, how it is possible, sir?
Intercultivation in
sweet potato, how it is possible, sir?
Intercultivation sweet potato. Sweet potato, how is it possible in potato? See, intercultivation means, sir, earthing up. You have to carry out earthing up, no?
Using machinery, bullock cart.
Is there in the earthing up equipment is there? Tractor drawn implement also is there in potato. I don't know about sweet potato, but is there in potato? Okay.
In sweet potato, intercultivation using equipment, tractor, bullock, equipment not possible, sir. Sweet potato, because crops.
Veins, sir. That you are telling that is veins, that one, no? But initially, maybe it's required, no? We can carry it up to 25 days. Okay, yeah, I will check once, okay.
Possible through manually, sir, not possible through equipment, sir.
Means what is the reason you are telling? Why you are telling like that? Means there is that vegetative growth and that are mostly that veiny type of plant. That's why you are telling.
Yes, sir.
Spreading on the field. That's why.
Yes, sir.
Okay, but that is after that. What is that complete? What is the actual duration of sweet potato?
I think it may be 7 months, sir. 6 to 7 months.
Initial to 30 days, it's maybe possible. Okay, I will also check once. Okay. I will check once. Means you are telling that entering into the field is difficult due to that crop is entirely spread on the field. Is it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, I will check it. Okay, then coming to next aspect is according to length of field duration. Generally, your pulses, most of pulses other than your red gram, all other pulses is less than 90 days. Or even your green gram or black gram is 75 to 80 days. That is short duration. Then short duration crops, that is very short duration. Then short duration, your sunflower, cauliflower, and other upland rice, 75 to 100 days. Then medium duration crops, 100 to 125 days. That is wheat, jawar, bajra, groundnut, sesamum, jute. Then long duration, your mustard, tobacco, cotton up to 150 to 180. Okay. Then very long duration, above 150 days. That is sugarcane, red gram, castor, all these things. Then they are nothing more. And next is,
sir,
method of
harvest. Why that?
Yes.
Why that? Between this red gram and other pulses, right?
Red
why
gram
only red gram is different from all the other pulses?
Red gram is long duration crop. It's their genetical makeup. It's require a more for flowering and all those things require 150 to 180 days. That plant is like that only.
Okay.
The classified that plant is kept under legumes because of its having ability of nodule fixation and the flowering, whatever that flower time. Okay. But the duration is different. Again, the tamarindus. Okay. That is also under this family. Okay. That means this category, legumes category. the classification, the taxonomical classification based on one or two criteria. There is no, they are not considered duration of the crop. Okay. Right.
Okay.
Then sir, according to the method of harvesting. Is there any reason other than that? I don't know.
I don't know, sir.
Okay then. According to the method of harvesting. Generally in your rice and wheat, what we call? Wrapping. Then in case of your Bengal gram, black gram, or lentil or rapeseed, here we'll uproot the plant. Okay. Uproot the plant by pulling, and then after we go for threshing with the different, now whether there is the threshers are available. Now there is an your combined harvesters also available. Okay. Then coming to potato, sweet potato, groundnut or carrot, digging. Then picking cotton and vegetables. The harvesting of cotton is picking. Then vegetables also, brinjal, bhindi, chilies, we will pick that, whatever that economic pot, economic portion of that plant. Then primping, this is generally sometimes they are asking, what is the harvesting of tobacco is called as primming. Okay. Primming tobacco. Then cutting, Belsium, Napier, or your, all the fodder crops will cut. Then grazing, paragrass, and stylobium. Means grazing means feeding directly to animals. Okay, open feeding. Then next one is according to post-harvest requirement. Okay, here curing tobacco and mustard is required. Curing. Yes, ma.
Tilo that sir curing mustard leaves partha ma.
Yeah. Tobacco tea. Is there is a different type of curing is there?
Tobacco and tea curing system.
Mustard
and okay. The curing.
Mustard.
Curing anedi leaves ki chestadi kada.
Curing yeah, there is curing is general leaves chestadi. But mustard, okay, in case of mustard, okay, I will check actually why they kept mustard. I will check it. Mustard is generally there is no curing. So I will this mustard I will check once, and while giving you PPT I will change it.
Sir, mustard harvested the time of pods, they are harvested at pods, capsules are in green yes. Stage, sir.
Yeah, but to avoid shattering.
Yes, sir. After harvesting, they are dried under sun, sir. Sun drying.
Under shade.
Yes, sir.
Not
shade, sir. Under sun. Sunlight.
Sun drying. Okay.
Because curing, sir, name.
That is called as curing?
Yes, sir.
Okay, just I will also check it. Actually, I'm also not aware. Okay. Tobacco, we have a different curing. Sun curing, then pit curing. Different type of curing. Based on that also, flue curing. Okay. That is tobacco. Then stripping. What is stripping? What is stripping?
Fiber extraction.
Removal of fiber.
Extraction. Then other term is related to jute.
Retting.
What is retting?
Soaking of this fiber under water.
Soaking
or loosening of the fibers.
Soaking of the stems in the under water. To loosening the fiber and to there is a different to my increase to enhance the microbial activity, that is retting.
Keeping under.
Keeping
making into bundles.
Soaking under water. Okay. Yes, ma'am. That is retting. Retting followed by stripping. Stripping is extraction and retting is loosening. Okay. Then coming to selling, groundnut. Selling means whatever that seeds collection, whatever that by crushing that seed, whatever that we complete that pot. Yes, amma?
Rice lo kuda selling chestam
kada. Rice lo? Rice lo selling chestam amma?
Hulling.
Milling.
Okay.
Hulling. That is hulling, milling. That is means removal of that pericarp part, whatever that. Okay,
selling
that is hulling.
Corn lo kuda chestam.
Selling in your groundnut.
Corn lo kuda chestam sir.
No, maize. Selling. Maize. Sellers is there. Okay. Hulling is means for mostly your whatever that this thing. ఏంటంటే వాట్ ఎవర్ యువర్ ఫ్యాడీ ఆర్ యువర్ వీట్ వాట్ దట్ ఈస్ హల్లింగ్ పర్సంటేజ్ హల్లింగ్ మీన్స్ ఎండ్ ప్రొడక్ట్ యువర్ ఇట్ ఇస్ రిమూవింగ్ ఆఫ్ దట్ పెరికార్ప్ ఆర్ వాట్ ఎవర్ హియర్ వీఆర్ రిమూవింగ్ దట్ యువర్ పాడ్ ఫ్రమ్ పాడ్స్ టు గెటింగ్ టు ఫ్రమ్ పాడ్స్ టు గెట్ దట్ సీడ్స్ ఈస్ సెల్లింగ్ హియర్ ఇన్ కేస్ ఆఫ్ మేస్ టు గెట్ దట్ కార్న్ ఆర్ మేస్ సీడ్స్ ఫ్రమ్ కౌ దట్ ఈస్ సెల్లింగ్ దెన్ కమింగ్ టు జిన్నింగ్ selling then ginning ginning is yes amma chepamma
aa em le sir ginning cotton antunna
ginning cotton ginning other than ginning any term related to cotton here
spinning
spinning is next process so once extraction of fiber is ginning from seed okay
linting
Delinting is different. Delinting is to facilitate sowing or removing the pods from. Okay. That is not forced. Means that is to facilitate seeds. Without delinting also you can sow the seeds. But the germination percentage will decrease or otherwise your that is a seed treatment. Delinting is a type of seed treatment. Okay. Then here is these are the post harvest techniques. Post harvest operations are to increase the value addition or to get the final product. Okay, that is cotton ginning. Then seasoning, the turmeric and chilies seasoning. Then grading and shortage that is common based on the quality. We have to remove that uniformity to maintain uniformity or homogeneity. Potato. Wheat fiber, okay. Rice, how rice and wheat? How will grading? How will grade? There is during milling. There is a means broken rice is there like that. We have to separate and we have to maintain homogeneity. These are the different terms. Here, your curing also is for your this one retting also is there. Other than jute and sunup, retting is related to another crop where we carry out retting. Here some of one another example is missing.
Again, sir.
No.
Jute.
Flax. Not okay. Mista is there. Okay, mista is there. Sun hemp is there. Flax. Okay, flax is or linseed.
Linseed.
Okay. Then based on crops growing, soil condition. This is also many times they are asking in our different exams. Okay, your those soils preferably grown like sandy soils, plasmophytes, lithophytes, ferns, rocks, rocky soils, rocks like rock that is ferns. Then coming to chasmophytes, rock charcoal rock that. Okay, I don't know actually what is it potato why. Chasmophytes, okay. Then coming to acidophytes, acid soils, potato. Then, if there's generally this potato is like grow well in acid soils. If you are grown potato in case of your alkali soils, there is a one disorder or disease is prevalent. Which is that one?
Pot of potato.
Potato stuff. Not clear.
Stubborn.
That if we are cultivated potato in alkali soils, there is a one disease generally prevalent. One common disease is there. What is the disease? A disease or disorder we call.
Otherwise, carbohydrate.
To grow, we control some disease or one disease to cultivate potato in acid soils.
Scabs, sir.
Scabs.
Streptomyces scabies.
Yes. Then coming to next one is alkali soils, basophytes, rice. Then calcifites, asparagus. Basic soils. This also calcifites. Okay, asparagus. Then coming to saline soils, halophytes, saline soil, calcifites, basic soil, basophytes, alkali soils. Acidophytes, acid soils, chasmophytes, rock cracks, Okay, it's I'm not aware of how it is in rock related to that. I will check it. Then lithophytes, rock surface ferns, then sandy cells, castor, then halophytes, sugar beet, alfalfa. Then based on climatic condition, tropical crops, coconut, sugarcane, these are tropical crops, subtropical crops, rice, cotton, temperate crops, wheat, barley, polar crops, all pines, pasture grasses. Okay, all temperate crops are based on photoperiodism. Photoperiod requirement. All temperate crops required which type of photoperiod? How?
Which long type day. Long day.
Long day. So that is, then next one is one of the important another aspect terminology related. According to important uses, catch crops. Shall we stop here? Otherwise, you have a class again in 5:30. Agriculture. Okay. Yes. Will continue or stop here?
Also.
Okay. Okay. Any doubt up to this? Just I will from my side, I will check one that 2-3 aspects I was noted already. I have remember that. Other than that, any doubt?
Sir.
Yeah.
So which content more moisture, hay or silage, sir?
Moisture content.
Yes, sir.
Moisture content is, I think, hay is completely, hay is maybe hay. Actually, in case of your silage is fermented only. Okay. Maybe hay. I'm not sure. I will check.
Okay. Okay, sir.
If you know, you tell me. You are find that type of question somewhere.
Yes, sir.
What they given?
Examples, sir. Which one of the following crop used as hay?
Yeah, that is okay. Hay and silage is a different. We discussed already now. But which one having highest moisture? Hay means nothing but will dry. That whatever the harvested fodder, but that greeniness not going to lose, that greeniness that will conserve that greeniness, say drying, and in case of silage, will conserve or will store that, they will keep that in silage pits where anaerobic condition and further that fermentation process happen, and after that is something that acidic in taste. And the palatability increase, and cattle is the palatability of cattle increase, and that is one of the good food. And same time, some urea spraying of urea or some other nutrients also we are carried out, and that increase the nutritional content also. Then regarding moisture content, if the means here I know one thing, if some more moisture content in silage means that is bad quality. If that is, there is a limit of moisture is there, I will check it. But which one is having highest comparing to hay or silage, I am not aware. I will check. Okay. If anything they are given there?
No, sir. They asked which one of the following crops, sir.
Following crops are, which one of the following is hay or silage? They are, but regarding moisture, I am asking.
No, sir, they are not mentioned about moisture.
Okay, I will check and we will discuss. Okay, no problem. I will check and we will discuss. Otherwise, we have a separate class regarding the silage maize by animal husbandry person. Okay. Okay, then no problem. Then next one, we will. Other than that?
No, sir.
Anyone? Okay. So, we will come back. We will join again, rejoin at 5:30. The sericulture. Class is regarding sericulture.